Welcome aboard Montreal's REM. We're going to be riding and checking out the stations, checking out the trains. It's all coming up on North Country Trains. Let's get into it right now. Montreal just inaugurated what is possibly the most futuristic and modern transit in North America, and living an hour away, I couldn't pass up the chance to check it out firsthand. The REM project is a multi-phase, ambitious, autonomous light rail system in the Montreal metro area. We have lots to explore and unpack, but I'll get into the specifics a little later on. First stop, Brossard Station, conveniently located on my drive towards the city. I'm here in Brossard, Quebec, checking out the brand new REM light rail metro that just opened in Montreal yesterday. This thing is brand new, and we're gonna ride it on North Country Trains. At Brossard, nearly 3,000 parking spaces are provided, over 2,000 being free. The REM's massive maintenance and testing facility is nearby. Brossard Station is very nice, and this is actually only one of three stations here in Brossard. There are two in Montreal, one technically on Nuns Island and then Central Station. There will be many, many more stations coming soon, but this is just the first phase of a multi-phase, actually potentially multi-line system. The trains are up there. Looks like there's a bit of a line to get some tickets, so it's popular. It's only the second day, but a very nice terminal station.
We had to wait quite a while to buy tickets at one of only two machines in the station. The delay eventually got so bad that a security guard told everyone just to get on the train. Of course, that happened right when it was my turn to buy a ticket, so I bought my day pass anyway. All five REM stations currently in operation feature an enclosed platform design with doors that match up with the doors on the trains. This sucks for rail fanning, but makes waiting for the train much safer and more comfortable.
Bienvenue à bord du REM. Direction Gare Centrale. Prochaine station du Quartier.
As we travel towards Central Station, let's discuss the reality of this project. It did cost at least $350 million more than expected, suffered multiple delays, and is far from completion. The entire REM line with its three branches will be fantastic when it's finally complete, which won't be for years. Additionally, last-minute issues and delays pushed the opening back until July 31st, 2023, and at least three operational issues came up within the first 48 hours. A switch problem on Monday morning halted the system during rush hour, three passengers found themselves in the Brossard Maintenance Center on Tuesday night, and computer system issues caused a minor disruption on Wednesday morning. With the system being fully automated, there is a degree of complexity, especially compared to the Detroit People Mover, which operates directionally in a loop. We are now heading west along the median of Autoroute 10, making stops at Du Quartier and Panama. These stations serve bus terminals, neighborhoods, apartments, and shopping centers.
Les portes s'ouvriront sur le côté gauche. Les portes s'ouvriront sur le côté gauche.
Unless you like watching the looks on drivers' faces as you overtake them in your shiny new train, which I happen to enjoy a lot, now is a great time to look around the train. The interior design is simple, meant for holding hundreds of passengers per train, and reminds me of a refreshed version of the Montreal Metro. Plenty of multi-use and accessible space is available, and while I'd like more seats, I must admit the use of space is pretty smart. Before you know it, we're flying over the Champlain Bridge, continuing to overtake traffic, especially during rush hour. We arrive on Nuns Island at another beautiful station before my favorite part of the ride. Up over the Via and Exo maintenance and layover yards, across CN's Point St. Charles Yard, and into the heart of the city. Unfortunately, this section of the REM has received somewhat justified backlash for the noise it makes as it travels by 20 hours a day. Standing at Point St. Charles, the sound was definitely very noticeable and potentially disrupting to those living near the right-of-way. We are now arriving in Central Station, just 18 minutes after departing the Brossard Terminal. To drive would take the same exact amount of time, plus any traffic delays, time spent finding and paying for parking, walking to Central Station or your other destination, and the stress of driving in a city. Well, maybe that last part only applies to people like me, but you get the idea. The REM area in Central Station fits well with both the other station designs as well as the muted, dark feel of the rest of the station. Transferring to Via Rail, intercity trains, or even the Metro is an incredibly seamless experience. Well, getting to the Metro would have been harder without Railfan Charles showing the way, but that's a topic for another video.
This is the new REM platform zone, and if you'll notice, there used to be tracks here. They paved over the tracks to create this. Now I gotta see, that's a little glitched. Two trains on track two. Now where's track two? I don't know.
Bienvenue à bord du REM. Direction A1. Brossard. Prochaine station, Île-des-Soeurs.
The REM is an incredible way to see the city between Central Station and Nuns Island.
Over. Here we go.
Prochaine station, Panama.
The view over the Champlain Bridge is great as well, and the line remains practical and useful through Brossard.
Les portes s'ouvriront sur le côté gauche.
I'm part of the demographic that doesn't live in the city or the suburbs, and I dislike traveling by car in urban areas.
Prochaine station, Brossard.
If I'm going somewhere very specific in Montreal, yes, I'll probably still drive. But if I'm just looking for a fast, easy way downtown or to Central Station, the rem will definitely be my go-to method.
Brossard.
It may have had a rough start, but the rem is the future of transit. If you're one of my regular viewers used to freight and intercity passenger videos, thanks for watching as I try something new. If transit is your interest, be sure to subscribe as well, as I'll be featuring more Montreal and Ottawa transit soon on the Canadian Rail series. I'm North Country Trains, thanks for watching.